did you end up from taking a ride down the river to owning a business here?
The old owner of this lodge, George Kelly, began hiring me as a guide my first year on the river, and his son and I became very good friends, and through several years of knowing Mike, found out that his dad was getting to a point where he wanted to get out of the business, and at that point with my wife and I, we had to make a decision of either staying in this business and doing it as a job and as a home and an opportunity to raise a family, or we were following her degree to some foreign country and and doing something very different than guiding fly fishermen.
Dan, why do you guide on the Bighorn?
Well, this is about one of the most famous rivers around, and the other reason, I'm a local. I'm born and raised 150 miles away, and this is my home. I love it.
How do you think the Bighorn compares to other famous Montana rivers like the Madison and the Yellowstone?
It's pretty hard to compare it to those. It's a lot different type of fishing. You know, those are, for one, our season's longer, which makes it, you know, it's pretty hard to compare when you can fish it 12 months a year. We don't have runoff, which is nice. You know, our definitely people probably go to those rivers for, you know, scenery more than anything, I think. They come here because, you know, you can have 40, 50 fish days, and you just don't see that very often on those other rivers.
It's one of the easiest places in the world to catch fish. For people who are not as skilled, they get a lot of opportunities on days they're biting.
Do you think the Bighorn is crowded?
Oh, it's a very popular river, but we also have 30 miles of water to fish with 6,000 fish per mile. And there's lots of spots, and most of the guides on the river are very good about finding spots away from the crowd.
What do you predict for the future of the river?
I predict it to be good. You know, with this higher water, the bugs are coming back, and I predict it to be really good the next few years with all the young fish. And so, good.
It's probably one of the most user-friendly rivers in the state. It has something for everyone.
Good.
It really does.
Very good. So you're happy here?
Mm-hmm. I am. It's a great place to be. It's a nice place to get your net wet a lot.
Well, we all like to see wet nets.
Yeah.
They all are pretty unique, and they all bring their own sense of professionalism to the river. Some of these guys have been doing this for 20-some years or more. But you have to look at John Kaiser as being one of the old professionals who's been around quite a long time and really enjoys what he does, and he's got a great sense of humor and makes the day go by fast.
First of all, the guides are unique. They're an unusual breed of person, and they are very knowledgeable and they're very helpful. And so to take an opportunity to fish with them is a gift. And then as far as fishing in the accommodations and all that sort of thing, where we stayed was great. The food is just out of this world. It's actually the best I've ever been to. And I've been fishing around the world, so to have them, you know, have the opportunity to stay here has been just really great. I loved it. Really loved it.
I mean, some of these meals we've had here have been incredible. It's gourmet quality meals that are just unique, and again, a nice variety of food, and it's just super.
It has been an incredible experience to raise two boys with an 80-acre backyard and a wild-producing trout stream running through it. Another unique opportunity that we have raising our family here is they have an extended family. And the extended family is a family that consists of guests from all over the world to guides, lodge staff, and a chef.
What would be your favorite section of the river to fish?
Where the fish are biting.
The one I'm on. At the time.
Definitely Mallard to Two Leggins, the lower section. Not nearly as many fish, but the fish are big.
I like the spot where the fish are.
Good. That's a very good answer.
In that wet spot, you know.
I let my soul float down the green river, and my summer. So float on up to the Rochester Dam. I'll be halfway home with paradise waiting 5 wet miles away from